Since 2000, the FDA has received more than 95,000 reports of medication errors, preventable events that may cause harm to a patient. Why do these errors happen, and how can they be reduced? I'm Captain Mary Kremsner, and this is Drug Info Rounds, brought to you by the pharmacists in the FDA's Division of Drug Information. I'm joined today by two FDA pharmacists, Commander Jay Hong, Lieutenant Commander Sam Scaraya, to discuss medication errors and what the FDA does to prevent them. So Jay, what are some of the main causes of medication errors?
Usually, there are multiple complex factors at play. For example, it could be some combination of illegible handwriting, packaging design that looks alike, or similarities in drug names and product characteristics, such as the drug strengths, dosage forms, and dosing intervals.
Jay, can you give us an example of a recent case that the FDA handled?
Sure. FDA's Division of Medication Error Prevention and Analysis recently reviewed and analyzed 226 reports related to the drugs risperidone, brand name risperidol, and ropinirole, brand name Requip. In some instances, patients who took the wrong medications were hospitalized. FDA's analysis revealed an increase in confusion between these drugs after the generic versions for both were introduced. Both brand and generic similarity was a prime suspect. Other possible factors included illegible handwriting on prescriptions and similarities in the container labels and carton packaging within the generic product lines. You can see the labels are almost identical. Because both products started with R, they could have been stocked near each other on shelves.
The FDA requested that drug manufacturers use tall man lettering on labels and packaging to make the names more distinct. We also requested changes to the generic labels and cartons so that the fonts, layout, and colors are no longer similar. We advised healthcare professionals to clearly print the drug names on written prescriptions, spell out the drug names for phone prescriptions, and to verify the purpose of the drugs with their patients. We asked pharmacists to physically separate stocks of the drugs and confirm the drug name with prescribers if the prescription is not legible.
Sam, what does FDA do on a regular basis to reduce the risk of medication errors?
Well, plenty. Each month, the FDA reviews and analyzes approximately 1,400 reports of medication errors that come through MedWatch, which is the FDA's adverse event reporting program. We conduct pre-marketing reviews of all proprietary drug names, labeling, and packaging to minimize the potential for confusion. Since 2004, the FDA has required barcodes on product labels for certain drugs and biologics like blood. Barcodes help ensure the right dose of the right drug at the right time. Last but certainly not least, we educate the public. The FDA spreads messages about medication error prevention through public health advisories, medication guides, and outreach partnerships with other organizations.
It sounds like all parts of the healthcare system, from medical professionals to patients themselves, play a critical role in preventing and reporting medication errors. You can easily report any adverse events or potential medication errors through the MedWatch website. If you have questions about medication errors, call or email the FDA's Division of Drug Information.